Good afternoon, everyone. This is Pitamber Dhakal, management learner, MIT Business School. And today I've got an opportunity to speak on a topic. I thank our Dean Sir, HOD Sir, and all the faculty members. And today, under the supervision of Dr. Anant Lakshendra Sir, I would like to elaborate on a topic of legal aspects, Information Technology Act 2000. The Information Technology Act or IT Act 2000 was notified on October 17, 2000. It is the law that deals with the cyber crime and electronic commerce in India. In this article, we will look at the objectives, features and importance of this IT Act 2000, and as well as in addition, we will study about the digital signature and its importance. Information Technology Act 2000. In 1996, the United Nations Commission on International Trade Law adopted the Model Law on Electronic Commerce to bring uniformity in the law in different countries. Further, the General Assembly of the United Nations recommended that all countries must consider this Model Law and make changes in their own cyber laws. India became the 12th country to enable cyber law after it passed the IT Act 2000. Now we will study the objectives of the IT Act. The Information Technology Act 2000 provides legal recognition to the transactions done via electronic exchange of data and other electronic means of communication. This also involves the use of alternative to a paper-based method of communication and information storage to facilitate the electronic filing of documents with the government agencies. Now, it also facilitates the electronic filing of documents, as we have studied it. It facilitates the electronic storage of data also, give legal sanction, and also facilitate the electronic transfer of funds between banks and other financial institutions. Now we will study about the features of the IT Act 2000. All electronic contracts are made through secure electronic channels and are legally valid. Legal recognitions for all the digital signatures. Security measures for electronic records and also digital signatures are in place. Provision of establishing a cyber regulatory appellant tribunal under the Act. Further, this tribunal will handle all the appeals made against the order of controller of adjudicating officer. Now we will see the applicability and non-applicability of the Act. First, the applicability of the Act in India. According to Section 1, second, the Act extends to the entire country, which includes Jammu and Kashmir. In order to include Jammu and Kashmir, this Act uses the Article 253 of the Constitution. Further, it does not take citizenship into account and provides extra-territorial jurisdiction. And now we will see the non-applicability of the IT Act 2000. Execution, according to the Section 1, 4 of the Information Technology Act 2000, the Act is not applicable to the following document: execution of negotiable instrument under Negotiable Instruments Act 1881, except checks; execution of a power of attorney under the Powers of Attorney Act 1882; creation of trust under the Indian Trust Act 1882; execution of a will under the Indian Succession Act 1925, including any other testamentary disposition by whatever name called. Now we will move towards our next important topic of the day, digital signature. Digital signature is a mathematical scheme to verify the authenticity of digital documents or messages. Also, a valid signature, digital signature, allows the recipient to trust the fact that a known sender has sent the message and it was not altered in transit. In this article, we will look at the sections of the Information Act 2000 which deal with digital certificates. Like written signatures, digital signatures provide authentication of the associated input or messages. Now we will move towards the three important features of digital signature. They are authentication, integrity, and non-repudiation. Now coming to the authentication, they authenticate the source of message. Since the ownership of a digital certificate is bound to a specific user, the signature shows that the user has sent it. Integrity. Sometimes the sender and the receiver of the message needs an assurance that the message was not altered during transmission. A digital certificate provides this feature. Non-repudiation, a sender cannot deny sending a message which has a digital signature on it. According to the Information Technology Act 2000, the digital signatures mean authentication of any electronic record by a subscriber by means of an electronic method or procedure in accordance. Thank you very much.